Port forwarding is an easy way to access Productivity Series controllers that are on their own network behind a router from the Productivity Suite software. But it's not a very secure way to access those controllers. So if network security is a concern for you, then you'll want to use a VPN to access your productivity controllers. We'll cover VPNs in a separate video. In this port forwarding demo, we'll be using a PC at this IP address, going to a router on the same subnet, but at .57. The Productivity 2000s that we'll be using will be behind that router on their local 192.168 network at these addresses. The port number that the Productivity Series controllers use to listen for Ethernet messages is 49s. To get the Productivity Suite software to communicate with the Productivity controllers, we'll send all of our messages to the router at address 172.31.51.57, but we'll append a unique port number to tell the router which Productivity controller we want to talk to. You can use anything you want, as long as it isn't already used on your network for something else. I'll use 41s for controller number 1 and 42s for controller number 2 just so it's easy to remember. There's nothing special about those numbers. I just made them up because I don't have any other devices on this network to worry about. Inside the router, we'll set up a table to cross-reference those port numbers to the IP addresses of the local productivity controllers. So when the Productivity Suite software sends a message to this IP address and this port number, the router will look in the table and will see that all messages with this port number are supposed to be forwarded to this controller. And all messages sent to this port number should be forwarded to this IP address. Hence the name port forwarding. We're using a Cisco Linksys E1000 router, and it has a dedicated port to connect to the external network and 4 ports for the local area network, or LAN. Let's connect the external network port on the router to the PC using this USB to Ethernet adapter. I've already set up that adapter's IP address to the 172.31.51.60 that we'll be using in this demo. Your network will have a different IP address, of course. That takes care of this connection. I'll connect a laptop to one of the 4 LAN ports on the router and set it to this IP address so we can configure the router using its default 192.168.1.1 IP address and use its built-in configuration utility. Finally, we'll add the Productivity controller's Ethernet connections to the LAN side of the router. I set up the Productivity controller's Ethernet IP addresses before we started this video. If you need to see how to configure the Ethernet port on the Productivity Series controller, check out the Productivity Ethernet Quick Start video. It shows you how to connect to the Productivity Series controllers over Ethernet. Okay, we're all wired up and the networking around the router is configured, so now we just need to set up the stuff inside the router. We configure the router from the laptop, which you can't see from this computer screen, so I'm just going to show you screenshots of what that looks like. From the laptop, I logged into the router using its default LAN IP address, which for this router is 192.168.1.1. There was a login screen, and for this Linksys E1000 router, the user and password were admin. In the basic setup menu, this router was set up for DHCP, so it would get its IP address automatically from the network. I changed it to this static IP address to ensure the router is on the same subnet as the PC with the Productivity Suite software, which was at 172.31.51.60. So I just set the router at .57, so it would be different than the .60. And even though we don't have a gateway in our simple little demo here, this router required that I enter something, so I used this. If you are going through another router, then you'll want to add its IP address here as the gateway. I also had to go over to the security page and turn off this filter internet requests so I could ping the router and test my connection. Great, that takes care of the connection to the external world where our Productivity Suite software is. If I ping the router from the PC, sure enough I get a response. Perfect, this side of the router is ready to go. Now let's do the LAN side of the router. Back in the basic setup menu, we're using the router's default LAN IP address here with this subnet mask. And we don't need the DHCP since we're only talking to our Productivity Series controllers, which all have fixed IP addresses. I ping the Productivity controllers from the laptop, and sure enough I could reach both of them. So all the networking on this side of the router is working now. Great. I should mention that I also turned off the wireless functionality of this router. The IT guys here hate it when we bring up extraneous Wi-Fi signals. Okay, now it's time to connect this side of the router to this side. We do that with port forwarding, which on this router is under Applications and Gaming. You can see I gave each Productivity controller a name, specify the port numbers that will come from the Productivity Suite software on the PC, the local IP address of each Productivity controller, and the productivity controller's port number. That's the same fixed port number on every productivity controller. So any messages that come into the router on this port number will be forwarded to this IP address and this port number. Any messages that come in with this port number will be sent to this port number and IP address. Now here's a key point. The router you use has to have the ability to specify the productivity controller's port number like this. Some of the routers I tested wouldn't let me specify the productivity controller's port number, so I couldn't use those routers for port forwarding to a productivity controller. This Netgear router's port forwarding is a good example. I can specify a range of external ports coming into the router, but there's no place to put the productivity controller's port number, or what some routers call the internal port number. So watch out for that. Okay, we spent a lot of time talking about how to set up the network for port forwarding. But if you think about it, all we really did was wire the PC and the productivity controllers to the router, set up our networking addressing, and configured the router to talk to the PC and the productivity controllers and to forward messages. That's it. The bottom line is, all of this stuff we've done so far is stuff you need to do with your network, your router, and your IT guys. And while the router and your network will be different from this, hopefully you now have a better idea of what to look for and what you need to do. Great. Given all that networking and router stuff, setting up the Productivity Suite software to talk to the PLCs on the other side of the router is easy. Start the Productivity Suite software and start a new project. This is the CPU we're using, so hit continue. Let's connect to this productivity controller on the other side of the router. CPU, choose CPU. The Productivity Suite scans the network looking for compatible productivity hardware. There's a bunch of compatible controllers out there, but we don't see the ones we want that are on the other side of the router. Why not? Well, because the Productivity Suite can't see what's behind the router, so it can't automatically detect those PLCs. So what we need to do is set up a connection to that productivity controller by hitting this Add Connection button. Now we know the addressing information of those productivity controllers, so all we have to do is hit this Add Connection button and set it up. Here we type the IP address of the router, not the productivity controllers, and the port number that identifies which productivity controller we want to talk to. When we hit OK, just like always, the Productivity Suite software automatically scans the network and it finds the controller. Exactly what we expect. Now you just select that controller and hit Connect. And just like that, we're now looking at a productivity controller on the other side of the router. And we're ready to start coding our project. To look at the other controller, go offline, CPU, choose CPU. Add a connection to the router's IP address and add the port number that will tell the router which productivity controller to send the messages to. The Productivity Suite scans the network and there it is. You just highlight it and connect. Now we're talking to this productivity controller. So once you get your networking stuff all set up to do port forwarding, using it from the Productivity Suite software is simple. Just add a connection to the router and specify which port number. Easy. If you need any help with the Productivity Series controllers or any of Automation Direct's tens of thousands of parts, please contact Automation Direct's free, award-winning tech support during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. But please, don't call them looking for help on your router or your network setup. They aren't set up or trained to do that. And of course, don't forget the forums. There are lots of folks there that love to share their years of experience. Just don't post any questions directed at Automation Direct support team there. They don't monitor the forums on a regular basis.